Here we go creating form in the HTML. How we will learn how to create the form in the HTML. So form mostly used in the HTML for getting the input, getting some information from the user to the server and to process that information. So in order to create the form, we have created a file with the name form, and we have given the title to that file as form in HTML. And here we see a picture. Let's see, we wanted to create this type of form over here. Okay, so which first of all, if we see over here, it is written as register. Here we have to give the username, here we have to give the password, here we email, then gender we have to select, male, female, others, then phone we have to give some list of choices so that we can select it from there, and then we have to put some value, and in the last we have to submit that value. Now so first you see over here, it's written as register here. Okay, so for that we have to use, this is header, so we can use h1, even in this case h1, and right over there register. Okay, so save this over here, then in the form just right click over here. No, this is left aligned. I wanted to make it center line. So for that I simply have to use style attribute. In HTML5 we can use style attribute, in which we can say that text align, then we have to set it as center. Okay, here is the value center. So save it, again refresh it, this file, and you will see this is now aligned to the center of the page. Now look at this form. Form even also aligned to the center of the page. So in order to create the form, we have to use the element that is form. Okay, here again we have to use style and text align center. As we know that even the form is aligned to the center. Now so form is a container element that contain another elements, or even we can say that is not empty tag, it's having the starting tag and the closing tag. So first of all we have to display a label with the name user name. So for that, in order to create the label, we have to use label element, and the value to given is user name. Okay, and in that, after the username, there is the text box in which we have to set value. So for that we have to use another element that is called as the input. Here we can specify the which type of the input we want to do over there. So this is a simple text input in which we have to type simple text, so we just click it as text. So input, here we have to set the type equal to text. Here just in the last we just close this. Okay, now save this, and in the form we just refresh this. Now here we see username, and in the front of that there is a created as a text field. Got it. Next, in the next line we need to have password. We need to set the password. So here we again have to create the label, and in the label we have to put the value password, and after password we have to use input element. Then here we have to type now password, and password, when we have to type the password, it should not be displayed. Okay, it should not be displayed. or special character has to be displayed over there. So in this case, we can set the type as password. So whenever we set the password, it will not be displayed in actual. Some other character like star, hash, maybe displayed over there. So this way we just control S, save this. Now in the form, just save. Now look at the difference. Form over here is after username, the password is written in the new line. So in our case, the password and username are written in the same line. So in order to make it in the next line, we just have to put the break after this. So br element is used for making the break. So we just click it over here. Now see, there is no space between the two text field. Okay, there is no difference space between the two text field. As we see over here, there is some space between the text field. So in order to create the space over here, we need to have use style element over here, style, and here we can say that we have to give the margin from the top. So here we just have to set margin top. Okay, here margin top, we can set the margin. We have to set the unit value over here, like 1 2 3 4 5 6 up to so on, and these are the parameter by which we can set the margin. Okay, so here I set the margin as 5px. Px here stand for pixel. Save it. Now refresh it. Okay, so now look, the space of 5px is greater before this. Okay, the next line we need to have another label, that is email. Email, and in the front of that we again need a text box over there. So email, after that we need to have another element, that is input, and here we have to give the type. Now here we have to select the type as email, because whenever we have to specify the email is having a certain character, special character over there, like we have to use that special character is at the rate of sign, and we have to write some text before that, or we have to write some text after the symbol at the rate of. So for that we have to use the email over here, and just okay, and even we need to have some space over there, so we need to use style margin top. Here we specify again value 5px. Okay, and then we need to give br break over here. After this, even we need to have break. Save it and just go refreshing it. You will see. Now we know that some alignments is not in this part, that we can set using style sheet, CSS, or some lot of methods are there to do this. So say we left over there, some colons are left, as we see over here. Same way, here we have to save it. Now refresh it. Now this way we have created. In the next line we have to create, say, gender. So for that we have to create a label here. To the label we have to give the value gender. Okay, in the gender we just see three radio buttons and three choices over there, male, female, and other. So in order to create that, we have to use input here, type is radio. Okay, side. This is again the empty element, so we need now to, and again we have to create a label over there, and to this label we have to give the value male. Okay, then same procedure we have to follow. So we just copy this, control C, have a go with control B and another control B, and here we have to set the value female, and here the third option is other. Now save this, see the changes over there. Okay, so there is a three value after the gender. Again we have to put semicolon colon over here. So save it, refresh it. So in the front of gender we are having three options: either we have to select male, either we have to select female, either we have to select the other. No, in this case we are selecting male is also selected, female is also selected, and other is also selected. But one person can be only one at one time. He may be either male or either female or either other. So in order to make a single choice out of these options, we just have to use another type of attribute, that is name. And here we give the name as P, whatever the name we want to give, and we just also give name P. Name P. Now save this. If the choices has to be selected from these options, their name should be common. Okay, so here we have created three radio buttons with the option male, female and other, but the name given to the three radio button is same. It means it will allow us a single selection. Just click over this. If we click male, then if we click female, female is selected and male is unselected over there. If we select other, then previous choices. It means to say that we can make only single choice among the options. So after this we have to again put the break over here. In the another, say we just wanted to give big, we wanted to create another option over here, say qualification, say. So here we have to create a label and here we type qualification. Now a one person can have multiple qualifications, so we have to allow him to make multiple selection. In order to make him multiple selection, we use input type, here we use checkbox. And here we give the label school. We just give another three value over here. We just say either person can be a school, have completed his school, or he may be graduate, or he may be post graduate. So heavy value. And here we give the value postgraduate. Save here. Control S, save it. Refresh it. Now here we see the qualification. Here the checkboxes are they are in the front of this. We can make the multi, a person can be school, have Mercer may be having a qualification that he has completed his school, he might have completed his graduation, or he might have done post graduation. So in order to make multiple choices, we have to use another type over here, that is check boxes. But in case of radio button, we must have to make a single choice. A person either may be female, male, or other. So here in another our case, we need to have a phone number. Okay, so here we have to set the label. And value is phone. We just wanted to create a list of option for him. So in for that case, we just have to use another element over here, that is input type. Or we can use say list we can use another element over here for making such is select. In the select element, we have to use another element that is called as option, in which we have to set the options. So here we just give the option for country code. Say as we are from India, so we can give the country code option as 91 over here. Simultaneously, we just copy this. Control B. We just wanted to give him three options, 92 and the code 93. Just save this, and here we go with refresh. Now here we get another option over here, that is phone, and phone is coming with the three choices over here. So another, we have to enter the phone. For that, we need to have only simple input type. Text. So here again, we have to use BR to make the line. Control S, sorry, refresh it. So this way we just got there. So in the last, what we have to do, we have to make a button on which we have to create a submit button. So again, for that we have to use input type submit. Okay, and here we have to use another attribute and to give this value. Say we give this value as submit. Save it and refresh this form. You see, now a button is created on which the submit is having the value submit. Now if we want to change this value, instead of submit, we can create, give the value as click here. Save this. A submit button is created over here and having the value click here. Same way we can style it as style margin top we just again give the value 5x, save it, refresh. Okay, so this way we can create a simple form in the HTML. This way, I hope you have learned how to create the forms in the HTML. Okay, there are so many attributes and so many options that are available to use with the form and rest of the element that are used with the form, that you can further detail, you can learn it from the website, that is w3school.com. that is very useful website for learning and coding of HTML. So that's all for now. Good day.